G'day guys, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back for another episode of Wasteland Survival. So at the end of last week's episode, we started building a airlock at the end of the hangar, very similar to the one that we have down here in the control room. Now, basically what my plan is, if I didn't mention it in the last episode, I really can't remember if I did or not, but basically the plan is to create an airlock very similar to this one, if not exactly the same. And then from there we create a hallway, and off that hallway we have our rooms, like what we do have downstairs here behind the control room. And then at the end of the hallway, what we will have is another airlock. And then from there we will have an elevator shaft going upstairs. Now, one of the issues I need to try and solve is... Okay, so let me try and explain this properly. So if we go to the front here, this airlock here sits at a different distance from the edge of the mountain than the one upstairs. So let's say, for example, the door for the one upstairs comes to about here, or maybe it comes to about here, I'm not exactly sure. But basically, they aren't in the exact same location. So what I need to figure out is what the difference is between the location of these airlocks, and then from there I can basically determine how long the hallway needs to be, so that these two airlocks at the end, this one down here downstairs and the one upstairs, line up, so that when I go ahead and I actually create the elevator shaft, that also lines up. Because what I don't want to happen is, you know, build the airlock and then the hallway exactly the same size as this, and then I have a situation where, you know, the elevator shaft doesn't match, and then I've got to go ahead, grind everything down, and then redesign the whole lot. So I do have a few ideas on how to solve that, so yeah, we'll go through that. The other thing is, I'm not exactly sure what kind of rooms I'm going to put on the side of that hallway upstairs. So, you know, I was thinking maybe like a living quarters, and then maybe like a barracks, and maybe a mess hall, and then maybe something else. But it really depends on the length of the hallway as to what I can actually fit into that hallway. So, you know, obviously, I think this one is... I can't remember exactly how long it is, but I do remember that this one is odd, and they do share a common wall in between the rooms. So, yeah, I kind of got to figure out what the length of the hallway is, and then from there I can basically determine what I'm going to place in it. And then obviously after all of that, then we can go ahead and we can create the airlock on the back of this room, the airlock on the back of that room, the hallway, the rooms, and finally the elevator shaft that goes up to that. And then from there I can then create another I can extend the elevator shaft up to a third floor that then goes across to the control center that's going to sit right at the top of the mountain. So I need to kind of figure out the elevator as well, but I'm not sure if I will have time to do that in this episode. But before I go ahead and I do all of that, the first thing I actually need to do is go ahead and finish the airlock that is upstairs. And then once I've done that, I can figure out exactly how long the hallway needs to be, and I will show you how to do that. All right, guys, well, I'm going to head upstairs and we will go and get this done. And I think I've figured out with these reavers, so I thought one spawned. Wait, where is he? Yeah, there he is. So I'm pretty sure these reavers, they only spawn around the player. So I don't think I really need to worry about those guys spawning near the ice asteroid field that we made. Ice asteroid field, is that the right way to say it? The drilling rig that we set up, I don't think I really need to worry about that too much. So I don't think they're going to spawn near that and attack it. I think they're only going to continually spawn near me. So, all right, so obviously what I need to do now is just kind of finish this off. So what I need to, well, actually, you know what? The first thing I need to do though is I want to place a cargo container here so that I have easy access to stuff. So what I'll do is I'll weld this block up first, just so that I don't have to come back to it later. and we're going to withdraw a whole bunch of components for a small cargo container. Okay, well, I finally managed to get myself a whole bunch of components. Now what I want to do is obviously finish this off, and then I just want to check how much iron we have left. So I've got, looks like 90k there, and about 21, so about 112k. I wonder how many steel plates I can build with that. Actually no, I don't want to use that, I want to use this one. So let's see how many I can actually make. So I think, yeah, I'll probably go with 12,000 because I want to build a couple of other components with that, with those resources as well. So I think we should be okay. I think we should hopefully have enough to get at least this airlock done. And then basically from there we can get the hallway done. Alright, so but first what I need to do is I just want to place some blocks here. So that, in fact, are these the right colour? I don't think they are. Yep, they weren't. Alright, so place these blocks here and weld those up. Actually, I've got to weld this one up down the bottom. And the reason why I want to place blocks here is just so that there's no weird transitions, because sometimes when you have... Is that welded up? Yeah. Sometimes... when you don't have blocks joined together, you get this ugly grey line. So I kind of want to place blocks behind these so that... darn it. So that they kind of end up really flush. But anyway, I'm going to go and set up this room and get everything welded up. And then once I've done that, I shall return. Alright guys, welcome back. So, as you can see, I've mostly completed this airlock. Although there is one other thing I wanted to do before I go ahead and I'll weld up these blocks. So, my plan originally throughout the base was to actually add in some sensors so that these doors automatically open and close for us. But it's kind of something I've just... yeah, kind of not really done, but I thought maybe it was a good idea to do that now since all of these blocks aren't welded up and it's not going to be too much trouble to do that. So what I'll do is I'll just get rid of these blocks, and what I want to do is I basically want to place it directly under this block. So, but first, before I do that, I kind of need to work out exactly how far up I need to go. So the sensor is probably going to go on the front of that block. So hang on, let me just drill this out and then we can see exactly what we're doing. Oh cool, it seems like the... yeah, for some reason the drill isn't doing that funky thing anymore, so that's pretty cool. What I'll do is I'll drill directly under this block here. Actually, somebody in the comments mentioned they call this thing the Drill Salute, which I thought was pretty cool. That's a fantastic name for that. So whoever said that, that's awesome. All right, let's withdraw the components for one sensor, and let us see if it will actually allow us to place it. All right, so the problem with these sensors is that it won't let you place them unless there are no voxels intersecting with it. So let's drill that out a little bit further and let's see if it will let us place it now. Will it let us place it? Hang on. The only problem is I can't really see what I'm doing here. I think... so where is it intersecting? I think down there somewhere. Alright, so let's drill this part out a little bit more and let's see if it will let us place it now. Let's see. Ah, there we go. Alright, cool. So that there to my left is the top of the sensor. Cool, so we'll place it there like that. Right, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5 blocks to the top. So 5 times 2.5, yeah, is 10 meters. So hang on. No. 12.5 meters. So we want the left extent to be... Okay, so we want the bottom extent. I'll probably set that to about 2.5. So that's like that way. The top extent, I'll probably set that to 2.5. The back extent, we'll set this to 2.5 because that's behind the sensor and that will give us the height up until the top of the door. The front extent, we'll set that to 0.1. Now, the left and right extents, what do I need to set those to? So, obviously, we have three blocks. So, 1.25 plus 2.5 is 3.75. So, we will go left extent 3.75, and we'll go right extent 3.75. Now, what I could do is I could actually select the show on HUD feature, and then go into here and then show sensors field of range. Oh, does that actually work? I didn't think that worked unless you actually had a functional antenna. All right, so yeah, that kind of works out really good. So now I know exactly where the extents of this sensor are. So now what we got to do is give this thing a name and then set it up to actually open and close that door for us. And then what I'll do is I'll copy this and then I will name the door the same thing. So at the front will be sensor 1 and at the back will be sensor 2. So then what we do is we go and we give this gate a name. So we'll call this airlock gate 1. Awesome. And then what we'll do is we'll go back down here and we will name... We'll go set up actions, then we will find our gate. So we'll go gate 1, and then we'll go to open, and then closed. And then when I exit the range of the sensor, it should open and close that door. Fantastic. And then it opens for us, and then it closes. Now the question is, do I really want to be that close when it opens and closes? I might adjust... this range here a little bit, at least to the edge of that block. So that would be the top and the bottom extent. So what is that set to at the moment? So I need to add 1.25 to that. All right, so let's find our top extent is 2.5, so that'll be 3.75, and the bottom extent will be 3.75 again. And then now let's check it out and see how it looks. So now it should, yeah, awesome. All right, cool. So that works out pretty well. That's exactly, yeah. We can always play around with this later. So now basically what I got to do is replicate that whole process with the other door, but I'm not going to bore you with that because you've seen me do it once, so it's pretty much the same as seeing me do it twice. So I will go ahead and I will do that and then I will see you once that is done. Okay, welcome back. So as you can see, I finished off all of these interior blocks. The conveyor on the other side is done. So now what we need to do is run our tube across. Then from there, we need to put in the upside down catwalks. And then finally, after that, we need to put in the accent lights, exactly the same as what it is in every other room. So, and also another thing that I need to do here as well is basically go through and place in the air vents, because obviously I don't have an air vent here, and I need to basically get the tube that runs from that air vent there all the way through and then through to this point here. So that's another thing that I've got to do. But first, what I want to do is get rid of this cargo container here. Actually, what I'll do though is, just to be kind of a little bit smarter about this, I'm going to get rid of... well, first, let's make sure it's empty. Okay, cool. It's empty. So let's grind it down. Let's get rid of this block here. And then what I'll do is I'll just place the cargo container here so that I can still access it. And then we can just go ahead and replace that with an interior block later on. So now what I want to do is go ahead and grab a whole bunch of tubes. And I've basically just decided to stick with these tubes, just because of the fact that it would just be too hard at this point to try and replace them all with the, you know, the pipes. And as much as I do love the look of the pipes, I just think that would take me so much time, and I don't really think, how do I put it? The juice is not worth the squeeze, I would say. So, yeah, I'm just going to rock these standard old tubes, and yeah, we'll just go old school. Alright, cool, so that's done. And as you can see, that door is all centered up now, so that opens and closes very nicely. And then what we need to do is go ahead and place in our upside down catwalks. So we will quickly do that. And thankfully I haven't run out of resources doing all of this. Now, is it the right color? Yes, it is. Very nice. And then we'll just weld all these up. Okay, cool. Fantastic. So they're all welded up. Now I basically have to remember exactly where all of these lights go. Okay, so I figured out where all these lights have to go. So we need to place one in the center here. Now, the last time I placed one of these lights down, it was there. So that means the offset is going downwards because that's where I wanted it to go. Now, I'm pretty sure what I want is the offset to go this way. So what I'll do is I'll flip it like that. And then that should mean that the offset will go this way. So we'll place one there, one there, one there. And then we will spin this around. I'm not going to rotate it that way because then the offset will get will be in the direction that I don't want it to be. So let's go ahead and weld these up and pray that I have the materials on hand to do that, which it looks like I do. And then from there, what I need to do is kind of figure out what I set the other ones to. So fantastic. All right, cool. So it is finally complete. Now, I think what I'll do is I'll get this wired up because I guess why not? So what I want to do here, obviously, is I want to place in my air vent. And we're just going to vent all of the oxygen. So we're going to waste a little bit of oxygen doing this whole process, but it doesn't really matter too much. So we'll just drill all of this stuff out until we reach the other end. Okay, so we've reached the conveyor, so now all I need to do is run a tube all the way back, although as you can see my hole wasn't exactly very straight, but oh well, you get that. That's basically what I get for not creating a drill guide, although for something like this, yeah, I don't really think it's necessary. So okay, now all I gotta do is, like I said before, run the tube all the way back to this point, then we will place a conveyor junction here, and then underneath that we will place our air vent. So I'll quickly go away and I will do that, and then we should be good to go to start figuring out exactly how long this here hallway behind this airlock door needs to be. Alright, I will see you once we are done. Alright, so I've finally finished running the tube all the way to this point. Obviously above that we have our conveyor junction, and then we have our air vent, which has now been named so it looks nice in the menu. Alright, so now what I've got to do is kind of figure out where this airlock is in relation to the airlock downstairs, and then from there I can then figure out exactly how long I can actually make this hallway. So what I have done is, well, first we've got to actually wait for this thing to open. Come on, open quickly. Thank you. I am really tempted to change that airlock to just open instantly and not worry about the oxygen that is expelled when I open and close it. Alright, so what I've done is I've created this kind of a guide here. So what I am going to do is go back into the main base, so downstairs, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna place a projector right here. So let's go ahead and do that. So we will orientate this correctly. So, like that should be fine. Grab the materials for it. Weld it. Thank you. Alright. Now, I need to find this projector. So, I think it's this one. Yeah, okay, so projector. I'm just going to call this hallway. Hallway guide. Alright, so we'll do that. What we'll do is we'll find the blueprint, which is the drill guide. I believe it was hallway, upper hallway. Yep, so we'll select that. And let's see where that is. Okay, so what I basically want to do is move it across one and then move it forward one. So we'll go into that. So let's find the projector again. Hallway guide, horizontal offset, we'll move it across by one. Forward offset, we'll move it forward by one, and then it should be right in the center where this door is. Okay, so now let's head on back upstairs and see where this is actually poking through. And hopefully I've actually made this thing long enough where we can kind of see exactly what we have done, or see exactly where it's poking through. Okay, so wait for this door to open again. Come on, open sesame. There we go. Alright, so, as you can see, that is, so, the door for the airlock downstairs is basically here. And the door for the airlock here is obviously, you know, multiple blocks away from it. So, basically what that means is that if I was to make the hallway at the back of this airlock the same as the hallway downstairs, and then have an airlock on the end of both of those hallways that's the exact same length, what's going to happen is this airlock at the back of this hallway, blah 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 blah, will basically be, yeah, they won't line up. So I'll go to create a straight elevator shaft upwards, and then they're not going to line up. So what I need to make sure is that the elevator shaft will go all the way up and it will line up with everything nicely. So obviously we've got 1, 2, 3, and then looks like we have 4 blocks here. So that basically means that my hallway upstairs needs to be 4 blocks shorter than the hallway downstairs. So is that right? Is that what it needs to be? Okay, yeah, it appears that my brain is not working properly today. So, I've finally figured out this. So, if I was, like, let's say the door was where I'm standing right now. So, we would need to move this 1, 2, 3, and then 4 blocks back. So, we need to make the hallway, like I said originally, 4 blocks shorter. So what I need to do now is count the length of the other hallway and then just go 4 blocks shorter than that. So because it's an even number, and I think the hallway downstairs is also an even number, we will end up with an even amount of blocks again, like in length for the hallway. So let's go back into the hallway, and yeah, so this elevator shaft will be awesome once it's finished, because it means I don't really have to worry about this. Yeah, so basically we will go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then that is basically where our door is upstairs. So what I'll do is, just to double check that, is I'll move that forward. So let's go into the projector once more. Projector hanger. Hallway guide. Let's move that to position 5. And then that's obviously 1 plus 4. Alright, so we'll go back upstairs and we'll check that in a minute. But what I need to do now is count out exactly how long this hallway is. So we've got 1, 2, 3. Okay, so it looks like this is 25 blocks long, so obviously the hallway upstairs minus 4 needs to be 21 blocks long. So let's just go back upstairs and confirm that this little bit here is actually where we want it to be. So I want, well, this thing should theoretically show up right in the doorway, for the front door of the airlock upstairs, if that makes sense. It makes sense to me, kind of, but let's see if that is indeed the case. And like I said, I am really tempted to remove the airlock functionality of this door because it is getting to be quite annoying. Come on, door. Right, let's see where this has ended up. Fantastic. Okay, so that's exactly where it needs to be. Alright, so now we know that the doorway, or the hallway, I should say, rather, needs to be 21 blocks long. So now all we need to do is actually drill all of that out. But I do believe we have run into a slight issue, and that issue is that we no longer have any steel plates, if I am not mistaken. So let's have a look for steel plates in our inventory. No, I think I've still got a few. So, oh, 29,000. All right, fantastic. I thought I had a lot less than that. So I thought I was going to have to go out and do some mining, because when I was trying to withdraw steel plates before, it wouldn't let me. So I'm not sure why it was doing that. But yeah, it looks like I've got plenty to keep me going. Like, I've probably got, let's say, about 35,000 steel plates. So that should hopefully be enough to get this hallway done. Alright, now what I need to do is turn this projector back on. So let's... what did that do? I think that would have disconnected all of the connectors. Did it? No, I don't think it did. Oh, yeah, I'm glad it didn't. Oh, yeah, I think it's because they added that new functionality where things don't automatically get removed every time you press P, so P is not as monumentally bad as what it used to be. At least I hope that is the case. All right, let's find our projector. Projector hanger. In fact, I'm going to turn that one off. We're going to turn this one back on. And we are going to move this projection forward by maybe 10 blocks. And let's see roughly where that ends up. So, can I see those blocks? Nah, I can't see them. I'll figure that out. And then, so basically, I'm going to have to go away and drill this out. What I do want to check, though, is I just want to double check that after pressing P while sitting in that control seat, that all the ships are still actually connected to their respective connectors. The Atlas and the Pilgrim don't really matter so much because, you know, they're locked down by landing gears, but any of the other ships, it kind of does matter. So that one's locked. That one looks like it's locked as well. These two ships appear to be locked. But this has unlocked. Okay. Alright, so what we're going to have to do is lower the Nomad down and get that thing locked up again. So let's find our rear camera, which I believe is this one. And we've got to move this down a bit. So I think it's this way. Yeah, okay, cool. So that should be... Alright, number 8, ready to lock. Alright, so we'll lock that back onto the base. Fantastic. Alright. Now, note to self, do not press P. P is still bad. Yeah. Although it was kind of accidental, so I guess I can't beat myself up too much. Alright, cool. Yeah, close enough. Alright, like I said, I'm going to go away. I'm going to drill out that hallway. We're going to make a start on it. And then from there, we can kind of figure out exactly the dimensions of the rooms and what they're going to be and what rooms I'm actually going to place up there. So, all right, guys, I'll see you once that is all done. All right, guys. Well, as you can probably see as we walk through this door, I have completed drilling out the hallway. Now, right here is basically the point where the end of the hallway is, and this is basically where my door is going to be. Now, obviously from this point is going to be another airlock, and then at the end of this is going to be where my elevator shaft is. Now I've already pre-dug this hole here, and what I did is I actually did set up a template specifically for this purpose, and my goal here was to try and avoid having to actually like try and grind out this wall like by 2.5 blocks, and I'll try and show you what I mean. So basically the goal was not to have to deal with this sort of thing. So let's see if I can get this to place. So yeah, you see this one here where there's a little bit of the voxels showing through. I was kind of trying to avoid that by creating this template and drilling as straight as I possibly could, but alas, it seems as if it hasn't really worked. I think we should be alright for this level up here. As you can see, there's no voxels poking through on this one, but strangely enough, even though I followed the line on the dead center, this side here is perfectly fine. So I don't think I need to deal with that issue here. And yeah, as you can see, as I'm placing the block over, there's no voxels showing through. So on this side, at least, we should be fine. But yeah, for some reason on this side, there are a few spots where it's kind of showing through. Now, another issue that I kind of encountered, and I've encountered this issue many times before when I'm drilling things out, and you probably noticed it as I was flying through. You see these little bits of voxel here? Well, the problem is, let me just put my character down on the ground there. The problem is that I just can't get my drill to actually get rid of these little bits. So what I'm going to have to do is bring the mining ship in here and do that. And I know what you're thinking, but how in the heck am I going to get the mining ship in here? Well, there is something that you guys may or may not know about the mining ships that I've built. And yeah, you can see this really tiny little bit of voxel here. So obviously if I'm flying through it like, you know, 50 meters per second and I hit that, it's like hitting a solid brick wall. So it could actually kill me. Not to mention the fact that it just looks, you know, absolutely awful. So, all right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab the mining ship and I will show you a little trick with these mining ships that I've built. Okay, so as you can see, I've grabbed the mining ship from the back of the Nomad. Yeah, the Nomad. And I've brought it into the hangar, obviously. Also, one other thing I kind of wanted to mention was that I kind of forgot to actually check the ships in the hangar for the Atlas and make sure that they didn't drop to the ground and get damaged when I pressed P in that little console that has now been removed. And yeah, so it turns out that they're fine. For some reason, the only thing that managed to get disconnected was the actual, yeah, was the Nomad itself. So that was a bit strange to me. So yeah, but one thing I kind of wanted to demonstrate with this ship here in particular is that it can actually fit through these gates. So, but it seems that these doors aren't going to open because I'm in a small grid ship. So what I need to do is find these sensors. Actually, I think I need to search for airlock sensor. So we're going to select both of these, and what we're going to do is we are going to detect small ships. Awesome. So now when we get close to the door, it should actually open for us. And there we go. And yeah, as you can see, it's a little bit tight, but it does actually fit through. So I didn't really intend the ship to be this way. It kind of just happened by accident, and I thought it was a really cool feature that I thought I should show you guys. So yeah, if you are planning to build a ship with one of these gates as your airlock, then yeah, you can definitely get this ship through. So what we'll do is we will just left click drill this, because I don't really want to damage the walls. So I'll just left click drill that bit out. We'll go for this bit here. And I'm pretty sure there was another bit here. Ooh. Yeah, you see what I mean? Like, it's like a full-on solid wall. So, did I drill out any of the roof? No. I think we should be okay. All right, so now we can go ahead and we can take it back through this door. And we can put this thing back onto the Nomad. So, There we go. It's a little bit of a tight squeeze, but it does still fit. I thought I had my external camera. Ah, there we go. Let's just make sure we can get through this one, which obviously I know we can, but yeah, still. I still think this is pretty cool. It's a really tight squeeze, but if that wasn't the case, what I was planning to do was create like a drone with a remote control block on it. Like something really small with only one drill on it so that we could actually get those little bits of voxel. But for that, I basically would have had to put an antenna on that and then also activate my antenna. And then obviously put a remote control block on it as well. And that was something I really didn't want to do because obviously if the Reavers get within 10 kilometers of that antenna, they're going to detect that and then send their buddies after me. So, all right, let me go and connect this ship back up to the back of the Nomad and we'll go from there. Okay, well, I've basically placed the mining ship back where it was before, so now we can continue on with this hallway. So obviously, I think what I'm going to do first though is I'm going to start placing these blocks on the floor here, like these interior walls. And in fact, actually what I need to do before I even worry about that is I actually need to withdraw a whole bunch of components for those. But what I'll do is I will just withdraw interior plates, because that is the primary component that we need to actually build those walls. And it means that I can place down as many as I need and then just come back and weld them up later. So let's select our interior wall again. And I believe it is the right color. And I'll just kind of skip the ones where I can see a little bit of voxel showing through. And then we'll just have to kind of drill that voxel away a little bit. And as you can see, for some reason, on this side, there seems to be quite a lot of them. Yep, that should be... Well, yeah, so we got to leave those ones. This one should be fine. That should be fine. Well, it doesn't really matter with that one because that's where the door's going to be. That should... not so good, not so good, not so good. And that should be fine because it's basically where the wall is. I'm pretty sure this point is where my door is. So yeah, as I mentioned before, what I did was I put a projector downstairs with the same blueprint that we used to actually figure out where those front doors on each airlock were in relation to each other. And I put it at the rear door of the hallway to basically make sure that, you know, I didn't put my door in the wrong location in case I counted wrong. So what I'll do though is I haven't actually gone ahead and counted it out, so I think that's probably something I should do. So in between this point and that point over there, we should have 21 blocks. So let me just quickly count that out. So we got 1, 2, 21. Okay, fantastic. So that means that we are good to go. So yeah, like I said, all I got to do is place all the rest of the blocks, get everything welded up, which might take me quite a while. In fact, it took me about an hour just to drill this thing out. So the other thing is that I'm kind of hoping that we are back far enough into the valley where I can actually spawn, or not so much spawn, but build a decent room on the side of these hallways. So I'll show you what I mean. So if we head on back outside, I'll show you exactly what I mean by that. Okay, so we're back outside and it's pretty dark, so it's really hard to see. But if you guys remember, at the side of this hangar here, we have this like little bit of a valley here. So what I'm concerned about is that when I go ahead and I actually create the rooms on the side of that hallway, that the roof of that room is then going to poke through this part. So I'm kind of hoping that we are deep enough within the mountain that that's not going to happen, but I guess we'll just have to kind of play that by ear. I think this side is a little bit shallower than what... Of course it is a little bit shallower than what this side here is, so I think we should be able to get away with a bigger room on this side than we can on that side. But yeah, that's another thing that I'm gonna have to kind of figure out as well. So I dare say what I'll do is I will create the size of the room that I want, and then from there I'll project it out and just make sure that it doesn't actually pop through the side of the mountain. So, alright guys, well, I'm going to go ahead and weld a lot of this up, and once I've done that, I'll be back. Alright guys, welcome back. So, as you can see, I have finished laying down all of these interior blocks. And I've laid out the pipes about as far as I can go. And then also what I've done is I've placed a cargo container here on top of this conveyor. And this actually sits in the midpoint of the hallway. So I'm still not exactly sure about the layout of the rooms. That's probably something that I'm going to have to figure out once I get further into the build. But yeah, kind of run into an issue. Oh, and by the way, the Midas Weld Ship actually fits through these gates as well, which is nice. So the issue that I'm coming across now is that we have no more iron ingots. So I've got like 62 there, and then 0.7 there, well, 0.07. So yeah, I've got next to nothing when it comes to iron ingots. And if we go and have a look for small steel tubes, we have none of those. If we have a look for construction components, I've got quite a few of those. I've got quite a few interior plates, but not a whole heap. I actually burnt through a couple of thousand just building all of these interior plates. I've got plenty of girders. I suppose what I could do is I could just go ahead and reclaim some of these materials and then just, like, you know, change them back into iron ingots, but I don't think I really want to mess around with that. I think it's going to be better if we just go ahead and we go and mine some more iron. So yeah, that is exactly what we are going to do. I think one trip should do it. So I think I have enough steel plates, which is the thing that makes, well, the thing that takes up the most iron ingots to manufacture. Things like construction components, small steel tubes, and other bits and pieces like that don't tend to take up too much iron. So I think maybe doing one or two trips in the mining ship will be sufficient. And because I don't really want to take out the Nomad right now while I'm right in the middle of actually producing this whole setup. What am I looking for? The... Alright, so I think it was iron 6, maybe 9, maybe 12. I'm not exactly sure. Yeah, I think it was iron 6. Alright, so let's go into the mining ship and let's head on over there. Oh, by the way, one thing I'm kind of thinking about doing is I am getting annoyed with having to go through this hangar door all the time. So I think at a later stage as well, what I would love to do is maybe create a door on this side that kind of bypasses that door. But, you know, obviously it's just a standard door like one of these. Yeah, just your standard old door. And then from there, it'll come out to a catwalk, which will then kind of link up to this point here. And then we'll have a catwalk that goes over there and some stairs that lead up to it. I think it's a much more elegant solution than having to go through these hangar doors every single time we want to get in and out of the hangar, because yeah, it is getting quite tedious and it is getting quite annoying. And or the other option is, what I could do is I could do something similar to what I've done in my Mars base, and I could create like a door that is like maybe down here and then goes underneath these blocks here and then goes out, and it ends up on the left-hand side of that rock wall. Or we could also make the door on the side of the mountain that comes to this point. I would really love to make it symmetrical, but I don't think I'm really going to be able to do that unless I do them through the floor. So if we go and we have a look at this side, you can see that, you know, obviously there's my timer block. So we're already pretty close to the wall as it is. So I don't think I'll be able to put a door on this side. But I will definitely be able to put a door on that side. Or the second option is I could put like a door here that goes up a set of stairs. And I could also place a door there that also goes up a set of stairs. So yeah, that's something that I kind of want to think about, because the one thing I'm not exactly sure that I want to do is, do I or do I not want to make that thing, well, obviously it's going to be airtight, because, you know, it's going to be a tunnel with an airtight door on either end, but I'm not exactly sure if I want to make it big enough so that we can place an air vent in it and actually make it like a proper pressurized space. So that's one thing I've got to kind of think about. And yeah, because yeah, like I said, that door is just annoying me, and I'm kind of getting, yeah, just sick and tired of going through that door. Also, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to change those timer blocks, and I'm going to remove that whole timer block thing, because I think with the air vents extracting oxygen from the atmosphere and with all the sheer amount of, yeah, I just don't think it's really necessary anymore. Okay, so it seems like those two deposits are completely depleted. So let's head on over to this one. And I don't think I've ever mined this one before, so I should be able to grab everything that I need. Now the question is this thing empty? I got a little bit of stone, but that's alright. So, alright, let's, oh, it turns out that I have actually been here before. Oh yeah, this was the one that I went to in the middle of the night when I wanted to get some resources. This was quite a while ago too. I don't actually remember coming here, but it was pitch black when it was, so yeah, that's probably why I don't remember that. So, alright, I'm going to grab a load, take this back to the base, and yeah, we'll go from there. Okay, well that's the first load done, so let's take this back to base and get it all deposited in. And I think, you know what, I'm just going to leave the mining ship out just in case we need to get any more materials. I think we've got enough silicon and we've got enough nickel and cobalt and all the other little bits and pieces, but yeah, we definitely need this iron. So just in case I need to get myself some more resources, I'm just going to leave this on the connector out the front of the hangar. And I suppose that is what I built it for. Oh. Ooh. No, don't crash. No, don't crash. No, don't crash. Oh. Alright. Let's get out and inspect the damage. Oh, looks like I didn't really damage anything. Except for this connector, which I actually need to connect to the base. Oh no. Do I actually have the materials to repair this connector? Oh yes. Thank you. Thank you. That was totally my bad. It's been so long since I've actually used this mining ship in the atmosphere that I just, yeah, I kind of forget how much gravity there is on this planet. So I neglected to remember the gravity of the situation. Pardon the pun. All right, so let's get this thing connected and hopefully the refineries will just take everything out of this ship automatically. And it looks like that is what has happened. Hide empty. Okay, cool. So, all right, now we'll do one more trip and that should give us about 240,000 units worth of iron. So that should be plenty for what we need to build thus far. And then after that, after I've finished the hallway at least, then I'll take the Nomad out again and we'll do a massive mining trip for another couple of million units worth of iron. So, all right, let's mine just a little bit more. Alright, cool. Well, I think that should be plenty enough iron for what we need at this point in time. So we'll go ahead and we'll take this back to the base. And hopefully this should last us a little while. I can't exactly remember how many steel plates you can get from about 120,000 units worth of iron. But I think I spied before that we have about 30,000 steel plates. So yeah, like I said, I think that should be enough to get the hallway done. Although we will have to see how we go. Yeah. Like I said, I'm not used to flying this thing in the gravity, so it's this is going to be really sketchy for me. All right, let's try not to crash this time, shall we? All right, I think we're good. I think I've got the hang of this now. Alright, so I'll spin this thing around and I'll leave it facing this way because I want to be able to just jump in it and go pretty quickly, so I'm really not used to flying this thing in gravity. Alright, let's lock it down, turn the thrusters off. Fantastic. Okay, so we should have enough iron for what we need to do, so I'll see you back inside. Or maybe I will figure out exactly what I want to do with this kind of airlock underneath or on the side of the mountain, and then yeah, maybe we'll do that next instead. I'm not exactly sure, but obviously I need to wait for all this iron to refine as well, so I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, well, I've sort of made my decision on what I'm going to do next, so I am going to create this door because, like I said, this whole hangar situation is really annoying me. So, I think I've decided that I want to create it here. So maybe what we'll do is we'll do a door here, we'll do another door here. Obviously, they are going to be at different points sticking out, but we can kind of deal with that later. But what I want to do is I want to find the midpoint here. So let's withdraw a few steel plates. Do I have a connector somewhere where I can do that? Let's see, can I use this one? Yes, fantastic. I thought I had put conveyor sorters on that, so yeah, obviously. Interesting. Okay, where were we? Alright, so let's try and find the midpoint here. Hopefully it's an odd number and there actually is a midpoint. So how many blocks do we have here? So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so our midpoint is going to be here. So it's going to be... hang on. So we've got... yeah, basically 3 blocks below that. So, which will be at this point. So let's see. Is that lined up the same? Okay, yeah, cool. So, we need to go 3 blocks below. Wait, is that right? So we need to go... Alright, let me just work this out with stairs instead, because that's probably going to be the easy way to do it. So, what we want is I'm going to use these traditional stairs that I always use. What we want to do is behind this door, we're going to have some stairs that go underneath the airtight hangar doors themselves. So, they're going to have to be... so, let's just say, for example, it's going to be there. So, let me just withdraw the components for this. I do apologize if this is taking me ages to figure out, but it's sometimes hard to think about... What do you mean I don't have interior plates? Hang on. Let me try from this one. Thank you. Okay, let's try that again. So, we're going to have a set of stairs there. Then we're going to have another block here. And then we're going to have another set of Stairs. Where's my stairs? Here we go. And then we're gonna have another block. Wait, where's my block? There. And then another set of stairs like that. Yeah, so say if that was to move up one, then the set of stairs would be level with the floor. Well, do we need to go up four blocks? No, we need to have four sets of stairs. So that means I'm going to have to place another block behind this set of stairs and then another set of stairs on top of that. Because if I was to move these stairs up by one block, then these stairs would come to this point. And if I was to basically grind this block out, then the stairs would basically get me to here. But I still need another set of stairs to get above the deck of the hangar itself, if that makes sense. Kind of makes sense to me. So, all right, let's place that block back. So with that in mind, so if we need to go four blocks down, this whole contraption needs to be about eight blocks long. So where are we at this point? So I'm not exactly sure where I want to place these. I want to... yeah, we're going to have to figure this out a little bit better. So let's go back into the hangar and try and figure this out just before we end this episode, because it is getting quite long in the tooth. So I think what I want to do is maybe place them about a block away from here. So we'll make them this color. So we've got... okay, so we've got... alright, let's... so how many blocks away is that? So what I need to do though is this needs to be a minimum distance away from here, because underneath these airtight hangar doors, obviously they go down one block, but underneath those is another block. So I need to go down at least three blocks, which means I need to be six blocks away from this point here. So we need to be... so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... and then 6. So basically I need to start my stairs at this point. So we need to grind that out, grind these away, and then grind these back. And then my stairs basically need to start at this point here for me to actually be able to go underneath the hangar, or underneath the yeah, the airtight hangar doors. Now, does that actually look halfway decent? I think it's acceptable, to be honest with you. I think that should be fine. I think it'll look pretty good. And obviously, I think I'll do the same on the other side so that they look pretty good. Because I do like my symmetry. Although on that side, are the stairs at the same place? Yeah, they're at the same place. So yeah, I think that should be a pretty reasonable thing to do. I don't think I'll go ahead and I'll drill that out just yet. So if we're six blocks, let me just open this door, then that means we only need to go two blocks away from this point here. So yeah, we basically go 1, 2, and then that'll be another set of stairs. So we've got... wait, let me just make sure this is right. So we've got one set of stairs, two sets of stairs, wait, one set of stairs, two sets of stairs, and then three sets of stairs. Wait, I've made this one block further than I need to, or have I? You know what? I'm probably going to figure this out in between this episode and the next one, because this is kind of confusing me a little bit. Maybe it makes sense to you guys, but yeah, I'm just confusing myself. So I'll figure it all out and then I'll explain it. And yeah, so anyway, guys, I really hope you enjoyed that episode of Wasteland Survival. And I hope to see you in the next episode of Wasteland Survival. If you did like this episode, then consider leaving us a like and consider subscribing so that you do not miss the notifications for the next episode. And remember to smash that bell, guys. All right, thanks, guys. I will see you next time.